We're all super excited for the JAVELIN Bladder 100 trial. Just to remind the audience, this was a practice-changing trial that Professor Pauls presented at the ASCO 2020 virtual meeting as a plenary session. Subsequently, the paper was published on the New England Journal of Medicine on September 18, 2020, resulting in the change in guidelines in NCCN in U.S., European guidelines, and subsequent approval. It was by European Medicine Agency a few weeks ago. And the FDA had approved this approach at the end of June 2020. And this was a phase 3 randomized clinical trial with switch maintenance Avelumab plus best supportive care versus best supportive care alone in patients who had achieved response or stable disease to induction platinum-based chemotherapy in the frontline setting. So it was a frontline switch maintenance therapy trial evaluating, again, Avelumab as a single agent plus best supportive care or best supportive care alone in those with no progression on prior induction chemotherapy. The trial had shown overall survival benefit, hazard ratio 0.69 in all comers, regardless of PD-L1 expression. The degree of benefit was even higher in patients with PD-L1 high expression, but because of the robust and significant, statistically and clinical significant benefit with Avelumab in all comers and across different subsets of patients, this agent was approved in everybody who had a response or stable disease to induction chemotherapy. Many colleagues were asking, is there any difference in the magnitude or the degree of benefit with Avelumab based on the number of chemotherapy cycles that patients had received before, 4, 5, or 6 cycles of gemcitabine or gemcarbo. So we evaluated this question and we did a subset analysis and we saw that the benefit of Avelumab was independent and was consistent regardless of the duration of prior chemo and the number of prior chemo cycles. So 4, 5, or 6 cycles in all those subgroups of patients, Avelumab appeared to be very significant in terms of overall survival benefit, and the benefit appeared to be consistent. So my take on it is, you know, the decision about the number of cycles depends on the individual patient-level discussion between benefits and risks. Am I having a patient with significant response and benefit with manageable toxicity? This patient, I may go up to 6 cycles if the patient is struggling with toxicity, you know, neuropathy, fatigue, you know, cytopenias, and has a stable disease, I may stop at 4 cycles. So I think the decision about how many cycles to give of chemo depends on this individual benefit-risk ratio profile for each patient. But our report at ASCO GU2021 showed that the benefit of Avelumab appears to be regardless of the number of prior chemotherapy cycles.